Dear friends, welcome back. Today we are going to build an Arduino on a breadboard. It is very easy and it won't take us more than 5 minutes. I can hear you ask, why to bother when we can buy an Arduino Pro Mini for 2 euros? There are two reasons for that. The first one is that by building our own Arduino board, we can understand better the hardware of all Arduino boards and how that works. After building your own Arduino, you will have a deeper understanding of the Arduino software and hardware. The second reason to build a bare Arduino board is that the power consumption of that board is minimal. Have you imagined running your Arduino project on batteries for months or even years? With this Arduino bare board, that's possible. But let's start. The parts that are required are this: an ATMEGA328 microcontroller with Arduino bootloader. It is that chip here. It costs around 2 euros. We also need two 22 picofarads capacitors, this one here, one 100 nanofarad capacitors, this one here, a crystal at 16 megahertz, some wires, a USB to serial converter module. This is using an FTDI chip. We are going to need a resistor and of course an LED if we want to use the standard blink program. So let's begin by building our own Arduino on a breadboard. Let's start. First of all, we insert the microcontroller chip in the breadboard. Be careful to insert it correctly. The marking, that little dot here, you can see it, goes to the left. Now I'm going to place a sticker on it in order to be easier to connect it with the other parts. Okay, I have now put a sticker on the IC and we are ready to start connecting. You can find a file in the description of the video that you can print and make your own stickers. That will make your life a bit easier. First, we connect the crystal. The crystal goes to pins 9 and 10 that are marked as X1 and X2 on the sticker. So the crystal goes here. Next, we connect a 22 picofarad capacitor at pins 8 and 9, labeled as ground and X1. So X1 and ground. That capacitor goes here. Okay. Next, we connect another 22 picofarad capacitor between pins 8 and 10. Next, we have to connect VCC. VCC is pin number 7. Now we have to connect ground. Ground goes from pin number 8 to the breadboard ground. Now let's connect the LED. In order to use the standard blink program, we have to use the digital pin 13. So digital pin 13 is here and the resistor goes here. Now the positive of the LED goes to this way and all we have to do is to connect the other pin to the breadboard ground. Okay, we are now ready to power this project up. We are going to power it from this little power bank and as you can see, if I plug in the ground to the breadboard, our circuit started working and the LED is flashing. The IC, that integrated circuit, has no program loaded when you first buy it, except from the Arduino bootloader. So if you connect it, you won't see the LED flashing. You have to program it first. So let's see how to program this bare Arduino board. In order to program the integrated circuit, we are going to use a USB to serial converter and one 100 nanofarad capacitor. I have connected the capacitor to pin number 1, which is pin reset of the integrated circuit. So the first pin of the FTDI converter is named DTR. DTR pin goes to pin number 1 of the integrated circuit, but we have to connect it to the capacitor first. So we connect the first pin to the capacitor and the other pin of the capacitor to the reset pin of the microcontroller. Next, the second pin is named RX. RX pin goes to TX pin of the microcontroller, is pin number 3. The third pin of the converter is named TX, so TX pin goes to RX pin of the microcontroller, which is pin number 2. Now all we have to do is to connect two more pins. Pin number 4 is named VCC, so VCC goes to breadboard VCC. And the last pin of the converter, we don't have to use the fifth pin, the last pin is VCC, is ground, so ground goes to breadboard ground. So we are now ready to connect it with the computer. I will now plug in the USB in my computer. As you can see, Arduino is up and running, the LED is flashing, the FTDI converter provides power to the circuit. So let's now program it to blink the LED faster. I have made a simple sketch that puts LED on for 2 seconds and off for half a second. Let's upload it. I'm now pressing upload. Some LEDs will flash in the FTDI converter, and now we are going to see the sketch running. 2 seconds on, half a second off. That's how easy it is to program the breadboard Arduino. Let's now demonstrate the big advantage of the Arduino that is built in a breadboard. I have modified the blink LED program, so Arduino spends 8 seconds sleeping and lights up the LED for only 1 second. As you can see, when Arduino is sleeping, as it is right now, the power consumption is, the current is 0.07 or 6 milliamps. Can you see that? Now it's flashing. 0.076 milliamps. And when Arduino puts LED on, the current rises up to 36 or 37 milliamps. The power consumption when Arduino is sleeping is that low that we can power the breadboard Arduino from this power bank for over 4.5 years. Yes, that's correct. We can make an Arduino to run on batteries for years. A lot of projects can benefit from that. Imagine a weather station that can run on batteries for months or even years. I am really excited by this development as it increases the potential of the Arduino platform drastically. That's today's video. I hope that you like it and that it is useful for you. Many future projects are going to be built around this bare Arduino because of its extremely low power consumption. You can find the code of the project and the file for the stickers in the description of the video. Thank you very much and see you next week.